Good afternoon and welcome to Apple Vision Pro pre-order day. In my opinion, the Apple Vision Pro is the iPhone all over again. Yes, we've had a variety of amazing VR, mixed VR, AR experiences out there for years now. But at this point, I think we're all aware that Apple is usually not the first to show up to a party. But man, when they show up, that's about to be the most talked about party of the year. There are a ton of reasons from a filmmaking and photographer's perspective that I am so excited to be able to create a bunch of content with the Apple Vision Pro. So make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss out on February 2nd. As soon as this thing arrives, there's gonna be a lot of content. But just a few moments ago, Apple released the first kind of walkthrough experience video for the Apple Vision Pro, a much more slowed down version than their fast-paced promos where we all try to get, you know, super fast glimpses into how this thing functions. And now we get a nice 10-minute video to show the basic functionality, apps, and experiences that the Vision Pro will come with. But there are two moments in this 9-minute video that are actually pretty quick, but I think you, as my audience, will love to know. The first one is very quick near the end of the video, when the host announces that there will be over 1 million apps day one in a brand new version of the App Store, specifically designed for Vision Pro. And as the graphic scrolls down the interface, we can just catch a glimpse of compatible iPhone and iPad apps. And the first category is creative. And what do we see right there? The DaVinci Resolve logo. This means that on the Apple Vision Pro, DaVinci Resolve will natively be supported thanks to the utilization of the iPad app. Now, what will that experience look like? Will it just look like a big rectangle? That's my guess. But as we know, we can use a keyboard shortcut to unlock the full DaVinci Resolve, all 7 pages on the iPad. So in essence, we have native DaVinci Resolve support on the Apple Vision Pro. But if that's not good enough for you, here's the second coolest part. Earlier in the video, they talk about Sidecar. And we knew up to this point that the Vision Pro was going to be able to connect to the Mac in some way, but I didn't quite know exactly how it was going to work. And here we can see it looks to be as seamless as anything else that Apple does. It looks like in essence, I'll be able to grab my laptop, set it right here, open it up, and as long as the right Sidecar settings are enabled, same Apple ID, all that good stuff, then the magic can happen. Where it looks like the laptop screen will kind of just go black or stay blank, and if you're wearing the Vision Pro, your screen is going to pop up in front of you. And of course, you can move the screen around, resize it. And this is huge because this means I can essentially get rid of all this and literally just keep my laptop and all my editing keyboards, because you're still utilizing the peripherals of your computer. And since it's a AR experience, you'll be able to see everything. So I'll be able to see my speed editor, my mouse, my keyboard, but I can have my timeline huge, potentially wrapping around me. But the answer that I'm most fascinated to understand is if it will support multiple monitors, because that will be the true game-changing moment. Because of course, I have 2 monitors set up here. I used to have 3, and sometimes I go back and forth. But how amazing would it be to be able to choose at any given moment? Imagine being on an airplane, having a little Blackmagic speed editor right in front of you, or just your laptop with the basic keyboard. But then instead of having a, say, 13-inch MacBook Pro on your lap, you can now have 3 or 4 different monitors. You have a nice big clean feed. You got your timeline down here, your media bins, maybe some scopes over here. Now there's gonna be a lot of questions about, you know, the resolution, the color accuracy, and all that. So I don't think a true professional Hollywood colorist is maybe gonna use this from day one, even though I suspect Apple's gonna have very good color reproduction. And we know the resolution is above 4K in each eye, but still, I know it's not gonna immediately be the most industry professional standard, but I think for the majority of us content creators or video editors who are just always looking to push the latest envelopes of innovative tech, this could be a game changer for video editors. Even if you don't use Sidecar and you don't have a MacBook already, for $3,500, which is a decent price of a very powerful MacBook Pro, it looks like we're going to be able to have a very good editing computer. Now, I know what you're thinking with that. There's still plenty of questions and potential concerns. If you didn't have a MacBook Pro and you just have the, say, iPad version, how are you going to import your footage? What I imagine is everything is going to have to be cloud-based. So there will be some version of the Files app. And so anything that you can get into there, you'll be able to import. Obviously you'll import from the Photos app, maybe even AirDrop from an iPhone. So anyone used to those kind of Apple ecosystem workflows to import your footage should be a breeze. But the headset isn't exactly littered with USB-C and Thunderbolt ports. So true professional editors looking to edit off of hard drives or access servers and stuff, this is where you'll stick to having a Mac still and just using Sidecar so that you can have a more immersive editing experience. Honestly, as a creator who has not yet had any hands-on experience with the Vision Pro, I am beyond excited. I don't care if I sound like a fanboy right now. I literally have Think Different, which was Apple's mantra in the 90s with their ad campaign tattooed on my arm. But I'm just so excited to see where this goes and what worlds it opens up for us creators. Again, don't forget to get subscribed so you don't miss out on all this future Vision Pro content coming in a couple weeks. Let me know what videos you want me to make down in the comments as well. And speaking of the latest Apple innovations, if you want to hear my 3-month kind of follow-up review on Apple ProRes and Apple Log to see if they're worth it, check out this video right here.